pretty funny. It's weird.
What don't you like?
If one of these guys came down and this guy came down and this one became part of that, then I would start to like it. See how it works?
Yep.
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 That is so stupid looking, it's great.
It's so stupid looking?
Isn't it? It's just... Yeah.
When I first started researching Frank Gehry, I didn't really know much about him.
I knew he was a pretty successful architect and that he made some pretty weird buildings. But the more I researched about Frank Gehry, the more I realized that he was truly an exceptional person.
The first thing that sticks out to me is Frank's style, because he's so unique and different. So
this is kind of what the world's progressed to. Definitely good, kind of abstract art looking.
It looks like an ocean of like metally twistiness.
It's really cool to see what comes out of that guy's mind.
I like all the shapes.
There's probably a fine line between creativity and craziness. I'm sure he probably straddled that.
Some people don't like Frank's style because they think that he's being different. Just for the fact of being different.
Some of the stuff Frank Gehry makes just looks plain stupid.
At one point, Frank Gehry made a hat for Lady Gaga.
It definitely doesn't look like a hat, but it's definitely something Lady Gaga would wear.
I can see why he would do this for her, because she is really bizarre and really out there with all her attire and everything is so weird and just unique, and that's how Frank Gehry is.
My colleagues who were doing architecture that were my age and were making fun of what I was doing. So I didn't have much of a support system from them. I had a kind of blank stare. And here were these funny artists that I just loved, their work, were treating me like I was part of the team, you know? So this is in the Sainsbury wing, British Museum. It's a Hieronymus Bosch. If you look at it, this is a composition, and I start thinking of them as a composition of buildings. This is the floor plan of the Israeli project and creating a composition. Once I saw this that way, I mean, I'd actually seen this painting before and never connected with it like I did that day. And I got to the painting and it dropped me, you know, like I felt the ground cut out from under my legs. It was so powerful. And I saw it as architecture. I think that's what gives me confidence to do stuff when I see it. Once you get it embedded, you do it because you're confident that it's going to work.
You know, I don't think you and I have ever talked about how the architecture started.
I took a class in perspective with Mr. Workman, and I failed. I got an F. I couldn't stand it, so I went back and took it again and got an A. Then I took a class at USC in ceramics. The ceramic teacher said, I have a hunch you should take an architecture class. I'm going to enroll you at night. Every Monday night, there's an architecture class. I got an A in the class. And they recommended that I go into second year architecture. And then in the middle of second year, my teacher called me in and said, Frank, this isn't for you. You should get out of here. When he said it, it didn't mean shit to me. I didn't.
Oh, wait a minute now, come on. You mean this guy says to you, this is not for you, and it didn't devastate you?
It devastated me, but I didn't give up.
A lot of people think that famous people and really people that are very successful at what they do are just, they're just born with a sense of, you know, being better than everybody else. And that's really not true. In fact, it's quite opposite. Usually what happens is stars or people that are become really successful in later life, they fall and they drop harder than anybody else. But it's because of that far drop that allows them to pick themselves up higher and farther and greater than ever before. And being able to discover those personal defining moments in their life, I think, are huge.
He lacked a lot of confidence. He was talking often about being bankrupt, and he meant more than just monetary bankruptcy. He meant bankrupt in his relationships, bankrupt in his ability to get his clients to accept what he was doing.
I was struggling with the world I was confronted with, which is a commercial world. They weren't interested in what I was doing. And I talked to you about it one night, and you said that you faced the same commercial world and that you made peace with it by finding this small percentage of space in that commercial world where you could make a difference. Man, that was amazing to me, Sydney. I've never forgotten that.
Actually going to a Frank Gehry building and physically being there and filming it and seeing it for myself in 3D was an eye-opening experience.
It really made me think twice about the meaning of architecture.
It draws you to it. It's one of those things where it's like, I gotta go see what that is. I wanna go be inside there. I wanna see what's going on in there.
I mean, if you're walking around, you're like, oh my God, what the hell is there? You gotta check it out.
It's like really awesome.
There's so many shapes, twists, and turns. It really takes you back and makes you appreciate the building like a piece of art.
When you're constructing a building, do you think it's important to blend art and architecture together?
Oh, yes, I do. Yeah, both art and architecture together. Yeah, because it's going to be here a long time. You've got to look at it. You don't want just some big box.
I think that art and architecture should be combined because buildings should be a reflection of their city's personality.
A really cool thing about the EMP is that Frank Gehry designed it to look like Jimi Hendrix smashed a guitar. And I think that was really cool how we tried to combine the Seattle music scene into architecture.
I'm going to be frank with you. Frank is not a quitter. He never gave up. And I think that's the model everyone should follow when pursuing their dreams.
Frank Gehry is a pioneer. He's doing things that nobody's ever done before.
Frank Gehry has left a legacy for architects everywhere.
Frank Gehry is pushing the boundaries of what's possible with architecture.
All right, is there anything else you guys want to talk to people on YouTube, or anything else you want to say to everybody out there in the world?
I'm awesome. I'm really awesome.